Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome today to hear an update on the progress with respect to the planning for the Children's Hospital of Saskatchewan. I'd like to also acknowledge some of the other project team members that are with us today. In addition to Jackie on the project executive team, we also have Betty Beckler, the Director of Maternal and Children's Services, Patty Seminar, the Director of Emergency Services, Chris Arnold is a project lead, working with the project team on the executive team. Also a couple members from the architectural team, Keith Henry from Henry Downing Howlett Architects, and Clint Diener, the project manager with ZGF Architects, working with us on the project. Again, we welcome you all here today. I'd like to provide a high-level overview on the project and the work we've been completing to date. We want to remind everyone that the scope of the Children's Hospital of Saskatchewan project includes maternal and children's services, and it also includes development of a new adult and pediatric emergency department within the facility. The range of service will include pregnant women and mothers and their babies during pregnancy, during delivery, and after delivery, and we'll look after pediatric age children and teenagers up to the age of 18 years of age. Children's Hospital of Saskatchewan also has a significant provincial aspect to it. A number of services that we provide are delivered to citizens of the province outside of the Saskatoon Health Region. Just an indication of this population in our facilities, many patients who live outside Saskatoon but are cared for here include approximately 20% of the babies born at RUH, 41% of the babies that are cared for within the neonatal intensive care unit of RUH are from outside of the Saskatoon Health Region. Overall, approximately 45% of the children and teenagers who have inpatient stays in RUH come from outside of the Saskatoon Health Region. And on average, overall, about 20% of our adult emergency visits and 11% of our children and teenaged visits come from outside of the Saskatoon Health Region. Some of our challenges today in delivering that service are that currently a lot of the maternal and pediatric services are fragmented across different facilities at RUH. We have services, some are located in the 1955 building, some in the 1978 building, and others in the 1986 building, so there's fragmented areas and locations across that continuum of care. In addition to those age and diverse facilities, there is some current procedure that does happen at other sites. An example of that is day surgery, where there continues to be some pediatric day surgery completed at the St. Paul's Hospital site. The goal with the Children's Hospital of Saskatchewan, obviously, is to bring most of all these services together under one roof at the RUH site. I'd like to give you an overview of steps that we're going through to support the design and the building construction of the facility. This is basically segmented into four main areas or phases of work. We're currently in the schematic design phase of the project, nearing completion of a significant milestone on schematic design. We'll then be moving into design development. I'll talk a little bit about the purpose of each of those phases a little more in our time together. The next phase after design development is the construction documents. This is the working documents, the construction documents and blueprints that will guide the construction of the facility. And then the final phase, obviously, is the construction phase, the building of the facility. Overall, the target for substantial completion is December of 2015. This is the year of design. Schematic design, really what we're trying to do is understand the initial design of the building. We're looking at where services will be located in the building. We're trying to understand some of the key operational adjacencies with respect to the services that are located in the facility, understand which services need to be located together and need to work together. Overall, what we're trying to do through the schematic design workshops is gain that understanding overall for the facility. The schematic design workshops. We've had four rounds of those workshops. They typically occur over 1 week's time period. We have roughly 17 different user groups that we're working through. That involves overall over 200 people through all the working groups. Each of those groups has representation from families, staff and physicians. And what we do is we elaborate the information. After each workshop session, the architectural team goes away, comes back for the next round of meetings with enhanced plans to try and further develop the overall concept of the facility.
Oh. My daughter is 18 months. She's got cystic fibrosis. At 18 months, she's got a good solid 16 years of using a children's hospital. So for me, it's important to have input now when I still can. I try to think about both ends. I try to think of, okay, as a parent, what would I love and want, but then also how does that reflect and how the staff can work.
Thematic design user group process, very active and engaging process. Everyone's invigorated.
My name is Shelley Meyer and I'm a registered nurse on labor and delivery. Sometimes the higher up folks forget the little things that have to happen on the unit and the little things that are so important that the patients look for and the nursing staff looks for. And I didn't want any of those little things to be left out.
Through the applicant.
I guess what surprised me was how many different things there is to consider and to think about. It's also nice to get together with the other units and compare so that we can all be on the same page all the time.
So this is something that's very important to the general pediatricians.
Operational improvements that will be achieved in the facility.
And we think this is the beginning of improving the health care that we can provide for children, having a good layout and having the right facility so that we can really maximize our ability to care for children and use our skills.
I think that you're probably, I don't think there's enough space to store.
No, and I don't think it was there all.
My name's Jim Harmon. I'm a senior healthcare architect with CGF Architects in Seattle.
At the operational.
We've done children's hospitals in Denver and in Portland, and we're working on Seattle Children's Hospital right now. We will come out of this with a series of drawings which locate all of the various departments in their correct relationships to each other, define how the connections are made between the various departments.
All the recommendations relative to...
Here our real goal is to get the plans arranged so that everything's in the right place and it's pretty close to the right size.
Relative to the schematic.
We have a lot of programs that want to be on the same floor. So our building is relatively compact and so it's relatively broad. And that is leading us to a design solution which is going to be, I think, pretty unique.
Built on the site of what is currently part of the 1971-76 parking structure. From a programming and planning perspective, the majority of rooms.
It's really exciting to see how we can put our own personal touch on how we want to design our floor and how we can use the design to improve our ability to work together.
Well, I hope we can all come to an agreement as to what goes where. We're trying to fit as much as we can and make it as functional and as impressive as we can.
And they're very open to sort of letting us all speak our piece, and then what they come back with, I guess we'll see.
So the schematic design user group process, very active and engaging process. Everyone's invigorated and there's a lot of passion in developing the details of the project. So we appreciated everyone's input. In parallel to the schematic design effort, we are also completing a significant amount of work related to process improvements. What we're trying to do in that process is understand the current experience of patients and families in our facilities today. Through the application of lean tools and techniques, we're trying to understand all the aspects of care experienced during that care delivery process, and we're trying to look at potential non-value-added aspects of the flow so that we can make improvements, operational improvements that will be achieved in the facility to try and improve the experience of the patient, families, and staff in the future facility. We're segmenting the recommendations relative to the process improvements in kind of two main categories. The first is trying to identify potential recommendations that impact the schematic design or the physical aspects of the building itself. There also are a number of recommendations that are process related, where work plans need to be established to review and provide the operational improvements that are required on opening day of the facility. And again, we have a video that captures some of the thoughts and input in that process.
Our mission is to decrease the walking by 50%.
The design of the hospital can only take care of so much of your inefficiencies. You can build things as great as you want, but if you take bad processes with you, you're going to end up providing the same service. What lean truly is just a way of thinking. It's a way of looking at your processes and thinking and challenging the way that we currently do things.
I guess those of us who have been frontline staff for many years have said, you know, well, they never ask us. I mean, decisions are made and they never ask us. And this time when they came to us and said, will you be a part of it? We were going, ooh, I mean, we were excited.
They've spent two and a half months working on what does their process look like. And we always think we know what our processes look like until we start writing them down and mapping them out and understanding one person might do it a little bit differently than somebody else. And figuring those processes out.
You can capture that distance if you want. We write on 13 different pieces of paper when we admit a mom and a baby from labor and delivery. 13. Could my time be better spent doing something else? I think so.
Looking at how the patients flow and the families flow, and then engaged the supply groups and tried to understand how the medication flow goes in and the supplies, how all of those groups service the patients.
One of the groups actually did a mock patient transport, and they actually took one of the team members and put her in a gown and put a mask on her and actually ran her as a pediatric patient through some of the paths that the patient would travel with. She had a very eye-opening experience that she shared with the group, and it was very informative.
And the string model will actually show the stream of flow from basically the patients from the front door all the way through their process before they get discharged. So we're going to put this on the layout and actually show in a 3D format that path of flow.
What could we remove out of this system that might be wasteful? Distances walking or time spent on things that aren't adding any value to the patient experience. Out of these events, we've been capturing all of the ideas. There's lots of good ideas for things that we can do right now or things that, you know, in just the art of communication, understanding, oh, I didn't realize that's what you needed, or you know, the other department not realizing what times the schedule ran or the demands that are on that department.
It's not a one-time shot just with the design of this facility. It's a mindset that helps you move forward. So I think that's the strength we've seen in the process, and it's, again, it has forced us, I think, to work in different ways, and I think those are really healthy.
I hope that some of the things we've spoken about and people who actually have boots on the ground, if you will, I hope that some of our input has been taken into consideration and to make the patient experience and our experience as staff a little more fulfilling.
So all the recommendations relative to the schematic user groups and also the process improvement, the lean recommendations from those groups, those are all feeding in together to try and inform the final recommendations relative to the schematic design scheme for the building. Just wanted to mention a few of the other things that we've learned through the process. Just want to reconfirm that this Children's Hospital of Saskatchewan facility will be an addition immediately beside the 1978-86 building structure at RUH. It will be built on the site of what is currently part of the 1971-76 parking structure. From a programming and planning perspective, the majority of rooms in this facility will be private. We'll have enhanced capacity in those rooms for family visits and stays during the patient's care delivery. All of the rooms in the inpatient areas as well as the critical care areas of the facilities will be private for the most part. Through the lean improvement work and the user groups, we're studying the model for the nursing stations or the delivery of care within the units. So we're trying to take the learnings with respect to trying to understand such things as movement and travel distances for staff, looking at supply flows for medication and other supplies into the unit, and trying to look at optimizing locations of those nursing stations throughout the facility, particularly in the inpatient areas. We're also paying a lot of attention to circulation overall in the building. We're going to have dedicated patient elevators in the facility, but we're also trying to ensure that we can create some separations in the circulation, the movement and the flows of public traffic, patient traffic, and also the service traffic throughout the facility. So trying to separate out those primary flows and having dedicated circulation paths throughout the facility. One of the large floor plates that's contemplated in the building sees a large number of service areas together on one floor. This large floor plate includes neonatal intensive care, antepartum, the cesarean operating rooms, and labor and delivery in the current scheme. All of these are located together on one floor, further studying aspects of that. But right now the goal in planning is to try to understand these key adjacencies between these service areas and pay attention to the direct connections required within each of these components on that one floor. The operating rooms are looking at making same-sized operative delivery suites. Our current circumstance is only one of the current theaters would accommodate multiple births, so going out into the future we want to have flexibility in these operating theaters. Many service areas in the facilities are going to see quite a transformation. Neonatal intensive care is one where they're going to see quite a significant change in their physical environment. Currently all the isolettes in NICU are in an open care environment. We're moving to all private rooms in NICU. Again, those rooms will have capacity for family rooming in and overnight stays. So NICU is a good example of quite a transformation in their physical facilities in the new project. Trying to understand all the public and some of the key support areas of the facilities that are going to come together on the main floor lobby area. This will include such things as the spiritual care area, family resource center, child minding, registration, foundation, and some other key support areas are consolidated together. The surgical suite will have five operating rooms dedicated to pediatric surgery, including all pediatric day surgery. We've got a significant outpatient clinic component in the facility, and we're also going to be relocating the pediatric oncology outpatient program from the Saskatoon Cancer Center to the Children's Hospital facility. The planned emergency department, again, is going to have both adult and pediatric emergency. We're paying attention to zoning within that department to allow for dedicated areas for children and teenagers and also specific areas for adult emergency visits. But we're also cognizant of the need to have some shared spaces between these two areas. There are situations where everyone needs to support each other with common shared support spaces and specialized care areas within the department. The facility will have a helistop on the roof of the Children's Hospital, which will allow direct access for transferred patients coming in to go directly to the emergency department, as well as the pediatric surgical suite. So overall, another important consideration in the emergency department planning overall is looking at improving the patient and family experience, and also looking at such logistics as better connection and access for ambulance service to the facility as well. As I mentioned, the overall recommendations related to schematic design are being reviewed, and those approvals are to be achieved by the end of June. The schematic design submission will be presented to the authority and the Ministry of Health by the end of June of this year. So we're finalizing the milestone of schematic design. The next step is design development. Design development will be occurring through the fall of 2011 and into early 2012. With the approval milestone of design development, we would move into construction documents. We'll be basically doing those working drawings through 2012 with the goal to get to tender and start the construction period on the project in early 2013, again with substantial completion targeted for late 2015. The process improvement, again, just to mention that we are trying to capture those process improvement recommendations that are related to the schematic design or the physical building itself currently. And we also have significant ongoing work to do the appropriate prioritization, approvals, and all the improvement work related to those operational efficiencies that need to be gained and processes need to be put in place for the date when the facility does open. The design development stage, really what that is about, is taking the basic building plan that was the output of schematic design and starting to put the details to those plans. We're trying to look at such things as how individual rooms are set up, how areas of the facilities will look and operate, lobby areas, family areas, nursing station areas. All areas of the facility will be reviewed and established in detail. Also, to further the process improvement work during design development, we will be looking at opportunities where we're actually creating temporary mock-ups of areas of the facility to try and explore the experience in more detail. A good example would be the inpatient room itself, where we're going to look at alternative interior designs and layouts of that inpatient room to explore different alternatives with respect to how the furnishings, equipment, and the layout and the flow within that room will occur. So those are another key point of information and recommendations that are going to form the final design of the project. So by late 2011, we'll be in a good position to understand what the new hospital is going to be looking and feeling like. Significant involvement in the project thus far. We've talked about the user groups and the process improvement efforts. That has involved staff and physicians throughout those groups. We've also had significant participation from families with us. In the early phases of the project, I appreciated the support from the Maternal and Children's Patient and Family Advisory Council. They assisted us not only in the early functional programming related to the project, also the site validation work from June of last year through site tours, and also two family members are represented on our overall project steering committee. We've also set up a group of patient and family advisors on a working group. We do meet with this patient family working group on a monthly basis, and we'll continue to do so throughout the life of the project, giving those families an opportunity to identify areas of the project they're interested in discussing and having input on related to the design of the project. We're also continuing to look at enhancing opportunities to further engage the broader communities in the work of the project, recognizing that it is a lot of service from areas outside of the Saskatoon Health Region. One of the areas we're looking at in particular is the northern areas that have a high inflow of service volume into the Saskatoon facility. So we're looking at how we might be able to engage some key outlying areas to provide some input in the design development process. We also want to set up a children's advisory group. We'd like to understand a little better some of the experiences children have had in some of our facilities to date, and have them in a meaningful exercise to understand some of our high-level thinking and get some input into the design as it develops. We're also mindful of the cultural influences. A large community is supported through this facility, so we want to keep in mind some of the specific needs of such community members as First Nations, Métis, and new immigrant communities in our city and our province. Parking, as you know, is a challenge at all of our sites. During site validation, we understood the need and the priority that needs to be put on planning as it relates to parking. We've been completing significant work to study not only the parking capacity in the future when the Children's Hospital opens, but we're also trying to understand how we might be able to improve the overall traffic flow on the site, looking at entrances to and from the facility and trying to enhance the experience for all users at the RUH site. So we're nearing the end of finalizing some recommendations that will support not only the construction phase of the CHS, but also provide some longer-term solutions to look after the parking needs of the site. Just to remind everyone where we were at the time of the CHS site validation back in June of 2010, the building is still located in the same location, immediately adjacent to the 1978-86 RUH structure. Between those facilities and the 2002 parking structure. So the site of the CHS is on top of, as I mentioned, a portion of the 1971-76 parking structure. So the location of the facility remains the same. Through schematic design, we've been trying to understand how the organization of services and the overall shape, size, and massing of the facility, what it may be looking like. So that's the goal that we have at the end of schematic design. We're starting to understand a lot of the areas of the facility in regards to what their character and feel may be. This is just a few examples from early sketching that was done by the architectural team. This is back in the fall, trying to perhaps envision the view from the public lobby area of the facility out through to the River Valley just an idea of what that prominent view and location provides us. Also, with an understanding of how these services co-locate together, need to be together, and how they're stacked overall in the building, we're starting to get to the final stages of resolution and studying how the physical form of this building needs to respond to those adjacencies within the building itself. So where we're at is at a point in time in the project where a vision and shape is starting to form. This early design massing is not intended to be a design, rather just an indication of the massing size and character and location of the facility on the RUH campus and in the overall university campus. You can see that this facility is abutted to the existing RUH facilities, with the Dubé Center for Mental Health, Ellis Hall, being its next door neighbors. So the evolution continues. Again, we're excited about the key milestone of schematic design being able to be achieved in June of this year, and we look forward to developing it further through design development.